Hi, I'm Rachel Faulkner. I'm the Workplace Health Coordinator for Cornwall and the Isles of Scilly NHS Trust. We launched the new Cornwall and Isles of Scilly Healthy Workplace Award to enable workplaces to see hopefully what they're doing really well and maybe some gaps that we could improve on, specifically around staff health and wellbeing.
We've now got a silver award. We're now striving to get the gold award within the company. Obviously, Coastline Housing wants to be known as a good employer, and this is one of those things which I think will help to show that that's what we mean.
So my involvement initially was looking at a needs assessment to find out and engage with staff about actually what would make a difference to their working day and what sort of initiatives to promote health could we sort of help and support in doing that.
We've got a really good football team. We've joined a local five-a-side league. It's a very competitive league, but we have fun in counting how many goals have been scored against us. Actually, we've done quite well. There's 16 teams, I think we got to seventh. And we've had 10 or more players actually play in the team. So it's been good for everyone.
Different things suit different people. Some might want to do weight loss. Some might want to have their cholesterol checked. Some might need a flu jab. Over the course of the last year or so, I guess probably 60 or 70% of our staff have actually had some level of involvement with this initiative.
Team sports can boost morale, and I was very keen to try different ways of engagement to try and reduce the sickness levels. But we've achieved that. We've reduced the average by about 4 days over the last year. And I think in terms of team sports, we've certainly got pretty good buy-in from a good group of people across the organisation.
There's not a lot to organise with it. It doesn't have to be expensive. And the benefits are just huge, you know, not just for the company, but for the employees and their personal well-being and their morale. It's absolutely fantastic.
The pedometer challenge went on for 6 weeks. On the first 2 days of the challenge, I was only doing about 1,000 steps, and the target is about 10,000, so I realised I had to step it up a bit. I was getting to about 6,000 to 8,000 per day towards the end. I think it was good fun, giving me a chance to get, you know, out and about a bit more and, you know, realise that I was not doing enough exercise before.
Other initiatives with sun safety, for example, increasing education and awareness around the importance of sun safety.
Our next mall clinic is at Stiffians.
And we've also been able to set up the Healthy Boxes scheme where they get local fresh vegetables and fruit delivered.
We found a council initiative providing these healthy boxes at a very reasonable price that will deliver to the office on a weekly basis. So we just pay up on the Tuesday and the boxes are delivered the following Friday.
So really my involvement is just trying to give ideas and sort of signpost them to what's happening locally and to support that, but also, you know, what we can do around resources and tools and awareness campaigns that are already existing. The British Heart Foundation Think Fit manuals have been fantastic on promoting physical activity in the workplace, mental wellbeing in the workplace and healthy eating. So they can order these free of charge from the British Heart Foundation website. It really encourages and gives ideas to other workplaces about what they can do and what's worked well in other organisations.